Here we are for part two of the 2019 Daisy Nationals in Rogers, Arkansas. Last episode, we had just finished day one of the competition. In this episode, we'll talk to some more great folks, have a little shoot-off between Rick and Ben, and reveal the winners of the 2019 Daisy BB Gun Nationals. Stay tuned.
You know, when you're at a competition like this, there's so much tension and stress. You gotta let it out somehow. And that's what they do in this room. This is complete and utter madness in there. Evidently, you just take stuff in and you're trading everything. It's unbelievable what's going on in there. They're trading this, that, and the other thing. No money changes hands. It's just all 100% barter. This is pure pandemonium. Come take a look.
Red Rider 9, one of a kind. Should I trade for that?
All right, Ben, now we cannot come to a Daisy event with brand new air guns and not actually shoot them.
Yeah, you know, it seemed a little unfair. The kids are getting to have all the fun.
Yeah.
And we're just filming and talking. And so I decided, well, we better get in here, shoot these 599s a little bit. So.
All right. Before we do that, can I tell them about what this gun is?
Yeah, let's tell them.
So the 599 is a new gun from Daisy that's going to be a competitive option for the CMP program. So the three, they got the three position and that type of shooter, the sporter, the silhouettes, that kind of stuff. This gun is completely approved budget-wise, weight-wise, all of those parameters. It's been fully accepted by the CMP. So where before there were only a couple options, one of them was the Challenger, which now the price has gone up on that gun quite a bit.
Yeah, and this is giving it a run for its money.
Well,
so
I think
hear.
This has actually got more accuracy and it's more affordable. So with the sights, the gun, as you see here, adjustable trigger, a really nice match barrel, et cetera, et cetera. And look at the adjustability you have in the stock, which is pretty awesome. So this gun is running under $600.
That's awesome.
So that includes the
sights. Is that why they call it the 599?
Yeah. I hadn't thought of that, but I'm thinking maybe it was a 499 for the BB gun, 599. Yeah. But hey, you know, that's probably not a bad way to look at it. But it's got some heft to it. I mean, this is a serious competitive gun.
Yes, it's not a toy. This is definitely.
So pushing 520 feet per second, that's really where it tops out. And we're shooting some pellets here, and we'll see what we're shooting. We're shooting some wad cutters.
Daisy.
Just premium, flat-nosed, all right.
Yeah.
Well, I think what we need to do, Ben, because this has been handled by a bunch of children, and me. We need to take a couple practice shots just to see where we're at, and then I think we should go ahead and shoot a little competition. What do you think?
All right, what are going to be the rules here on this competition?
You know, I think what we should do is we should definitely shoot on the rest just to show the rifle off.
Sure.
And then we should shoot maybe standing.
Okay.
And show ourselves off a little bit, or the lack of it.
Yeah, or the lack of it.
All right.
Oh man, I have a feeling I really shanked that first one. Someone came blowing Rick's ear.
That was horrible.
Good. All right, I think I did less bad on that second one.
Stop it. My belly is a bad counterbalance. That's all I'm saying. I'll suck it in. Oh, okay. Oh, that was terrible.
All right. Terrible. Okay. That's what I want to hear.
That's who we got, Ben. All right, Ben. Let's cuss and discuss the results here, my friend.
Yeah, I'm going to be doing more cussing, I think.
Well, let's just say that the 599 is a badass rifle.
It's definitely got it going on. That is for sure. And that is very good, Rick. Wow.
That I was shocked.
I think what you actually did was you shot this when you were sitting down, and the two standing shots hit the wall behind it.
That must be, yeah. Now, I will absolutely take that all day long. Guys, if you're into this would be a great gun just to plink with in the backyard. I mean, take the precision sight away. If you want to teach somebody really good sight discipline,
absolutely,
good trigger discipline, good safety, all of that stuff, highly adjustable, just really good. And because it shoots at a low velocity, like the 520, it's great for 10 meter. You can probably stretch it out a little further too, but you get a ton of shots. So you're looking at, like, I think, correct me, it was 100 shots or so?
170 shots?
How many shots?
170. Wow.
Okay, they're telling me 170
awesome.
Shots out of this gun. So that just is awesome. Top it off with a hand pump, a little compressor, whatever, and you can shoot for days, literally.
Seriously.
And get those kind of results. And guys, I shoot a lot of air guns, but I am no marksman, and check that out.
Yeah. That's awesome.
That's pretty cool. All right, guys.
Very cool.
We're going to get back to the Daisy Nationals. There's some other guys that want to get up here and do some shoot with the 599. Stay with us. All right, guys. I'm here with Will from South Dakota. Now, there are three teams here from South Dakota. I happen to know those teams did very well in certain aspects of this competition. This is your third time here?
Yeah.
So you started when you were 8, you were telling me.
Yeah. I came here first when I was 10.
Wow, okay, so you started like right at the beginning.
Yep.
So you can actually tell the viewers out there, you know, really why this has been so important to you and why you enjoy it so much. So let them know exactly that.
Well, it's a good opportunity to just improve yourself and to get to work with coaches who are, it's just one-on-one with your coach. It's not a team sport where you have one coach and 20 kids or something. Do your best, I guess.
All right. Well, good luck. Are you still shooting today?
Yes.
Well, have you already started, or you still haven't?
No, we haven't started.
All right. So you got two positions left to do.
Yeah.
Well, good luck. We're going to see how you guys did closing ceremonies today. We're here with some more folks from South Dakota. We got Travis and Montana now. This is father-daughter going on here, right?
Yep.
All right. So how long have you been shooting?
For about 5 years.
Okay. And you've been to this competition how many times?
3 times.
That's some serious depth. Now, are you shooting this competition?
I am, as a tournament of champions.
Excellent. And that, are you just you against the other champions? Is that how that works?
Yep.
Not familiar how they play that one out. So it's you against all the other guys?
Mm-hmm.
How are you doing so far?
She's doing pretty
good.
Well.
I don't really know.
Yeah, but you'll find out tonight, right?
Tonight,
everybody's
going to
find out?
They'll find out tonight.
What really got you into the sport? What attracted it to you? Why do you like it?
I kind of wanted to learn about gun safety, and then when I was older, I was going to shoot more, and if I could possibly go to college for it.
Okay, so it's a scholarship.
Mm-hmm.
I've talked to a few kids that really understand that the BB gun competition leads to some sort of 10-meter precision or some sort of other discipline that actually can give you a full scholarship because you have shooting teams at these colleges. So it's serious. If you get the good fundamentals down with the BB gun, then those translate as you go forward. I mean, the same sort of shooting discipline, the trigger control, the positioning, the breathing, the self-discipline, the hold, all of that stuff, it translates forward and lets you be a better shooter as you move forward. As a dad, a little nerve-wracking?
Oh yeah, I don't usually load forward, but this year we did because so then the other coach that loaded forward can load for one of our team shooters.
Okay.
So I decided I'd load forward and we kind of butt heads at times, more often than not. So.
And why do you like it so much?
It teaches the kids gun safety and how to shoot and properly handle a gun.
Yeah.
I think, and it gives them an experience of competition. Some kids don't play sports, and some do. So the kids know what competition's like, and they have fun.
Teaches them some good mental discipline.
Yes. Yeah. Teaches a lot of people discipline. Yeah. Parents also and coaches. So.
Yeah, those times when you get up and you just don't want to practice. But you got to. If you're going to be good at something, you got to practice it. You got to practice often, and you got to practice right. And this is a great sport for that, because if you have a basement or a garage, or you have 5 meters in your backyard, or your back porch, or your living room, or whatever, you can do that with this sport, which I don't know any other sport that has that sort of availability for people to actually practice and get competitive. So that's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
All right, guys, thank you so much.
You.
Appreciate the time. Good luck today. Thanks. And I hope you do really well. And I'm thinking I'm pulling for these South Dakota teams. They seem to be doing pretty well so far in this competition. That's awesome.
To me, it's taught me that I can go under stress, and when something bad happens, that I can pull myself back together and maybe do very well.
There you go, because one bad shot does not equal a bad match, does it?
No.
And everybody has that bad shot, or that equipment malfunction, or the wobbly BB. You know, just because you have one little thing go wrong, that's not the end of the world. It actually, you have to get up.
It's taught me how to like talk to different people and make connections with them.
Mm-hmm.
And it teaches me patience.
Yeah.
It's been a really fun experience. I've been in it for 5 years now, and the growth that I've seen my shooters take on, the ability to handle and carry a gun, knowing gun safety, and just the way they've grown up with the respect, not only for guns, but for the people that they're with at the time. And it's going to relate down the road into the field and whatever he decides to do further on in life. So. It's a great program, and I recommend it for anybody.
We're a hunting family. So when I initially started, our son in it, it was kind of solely for the idea of, you know, how can I help him understand how the gun works, how gun safety works, and to do it properly. Then we just kind of fell in love with the sport, the competition side of it, and just kind of that one-on-one time that I get to spend with each of my kids while we're practicing. You know, we're huddled right there, right next to each other. It's a pretty special time to be able to spend with them. And
Get choked up now.
I didn't get choked up, but it does mean a lot.
So we're here with Mark, and Mark, where are you from?
From Topeka, Kansas.
Right.
Actually from Flint Hill Shooters, Alma, Kansas, Bunsen County.
All right, and I kind of wrangled Mark. Actually, we have some guys here that are doing the wrangling for us, but they about hog-tied him and brought him over here. And we want to talk about why you love being here, why you love the sport, why you love your child being involved in the BB gun shooting competition. So, Mark, you know, just try and tell the viewers, you know, anything in that you like, express it.
Man, I don't know if there's probably so much. I know that I started off, my first BB gun was a Daisy when I was a kid, and so I think about that a lot, and a lot of the trouble that I got in with it. I don't necessarily want him to get in trouble, but he likes guns, he likes to shoot, and I think the sport, since it's a learning sport, and it's sponsored through 4-H, and with the teaching that goes along with it, responsibility, it's just an awesome time. And then this group here at the Nationals and the whole group at Daisy makes it just an awesome time here at the town and Rogers and everything. It's just really nice. And throughout the year, all the matches that we shoot, the camaraderie that the kids have built, the friends that they made with other teams, it's cool.
Well, that is awesome, and I think you just nailed all the points. When you get the young shooters and they're involved in something that's organized, it's consistent, it's got good educational foundation, then they take that with them. And that's what this is really all about. So thank you so much for taking the time. That was awesome.
What I like about the competition is it teaches the kids how to work, how to earn something.
That's excellent.
And to be responsible, and you know, that's a good part of it.
That's great. And were you a competitive shooter?
I was.
Yeah, what did you shoot?
I shot rabbits.
Being here because I get the chance to shoot in front of a lot of people, and I like shooting airguns because I grew up shooting it, and it's really fun.
Awesome, right up here.
Hey guys, it's Rick Uster here again with AirgunWeb, AirgunWebTV, and we are at the 54th annual Daisy BB Gun Competition. As you can hear, the kids down there, they're having a great time because that's what it's all about. It's all about the kids. But it would never happen. I mean, not even come close to happening if it wasn't for this guy. This guy, his name is Eric, and he is the founder, creator, visionary that has started the Orion scoring system. And without that, really, this would be an impossibility to score this many targets, this many competitors, in any sort of reasonable time with the kind of accuracy that you can deliver. Just wouldn't happen. So Eric, tell me a little bit about your business, your company, just why you started the whole thing. Just, you know, give it. Let me know. Let me hear why it exists.
So the company we started about 10 years ago, and yes, we score targets. But one of my, the entire reasoning behind this was, you know, I'm an athlete myself, but I wanted to help promote shooting become a spectator sport.
I gotcha.
And you know, shooting will never become a spectator sport like you know football, basketball. But what we can do to make it appealing to spectators is to get results out quickly to make it have that live sense.
Sure.
And one of the first necessary steps to make that happen was to have digital scoring cheaply available to everybody.
Right, I got you.
And so that was the motivation behind the entire company to begin with.
Okay.
And so when I designed Orion, it was designed around the ideas of making it affordable so everybody could purchase it, making it quick for obvious reasons, and then putting the results out in a way that you know our society has come to want, meaning online
instant.
Results.
Yes. Yeah, instant.
Yeah, we have a version of the software we call it At Home. It's meant for the home-based athlete.
Yep.
It's under $300.
Wow, okay.
It has a, doesn't have as fast as a scanner for obvious reasons. It's under the $300 price point, but it's the exact same scoring solution that's being used here at the championships as used by bigger clubs. Yep. So under $300 for an individual athlete to have digital scoring.
That is phenomenal. Yeah, that actually, and I didn't even know that. I was thinking about the $700 price point, but you're talking about around $300. That is really, really good. Now, if they have a family with multiple shooters, can they all use it?
Yes.
That's awesome.
Yeah. At this championship, this, of course, the best of the best.
Yeah.
Almost everybody here uses Orion at their clubs.
Well, there you go. Affordable, accurate. I've looked at some of these BB targets. Frankly, I don't know how the computer does what it does, some secret sauce you've created to make it work, but it actually reads these things more accurate than a human could.
Yeah, absolutely. I was telling you earlier, it's a small miracle that we even can score a BB gun because BB guns, they're inexpensive for good reasons, but they make very poor shot holes.
Yeah.
And I had to figure out how to read these very poor shot holes.
Yeah.
And we were able to do it, thankfully. And the accuracy, most of the time, the accuracy even for BB gun is better than 10th of a millimeter.
Yeah, well, that is pretty awesome. So, well, I appreciate you for creating this and what you're doing and making it actually affordable. Even that family model, I have to actually now look at that because I've got a little girl that may have her start shooting. But that is pretty impressive. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you for taking the time to do this too, by the way. And I know this is probably a big event for you guys.
Yes, it is.
And so you've got you're back there in the score room with your team of guys. So they're working hard. They have about 2,000 cards to score over this event, which is a lot. So I'm gonna let you get back to work. Thanks for coming out.
I love BB from one aspect of my own kids.
Yep.
Being in the competition, they learn safety, they get educated about the rules, they learn range, safety, no matter what discipline they go. We watch them grow from small to large because they can start at age 8 and they can be in this competition until they're 15.
That's excellent.
That grows them up to the next level of air rifle, small bore rifle, muzzleloader, lots of other disciplines, and they can go out and be lifetime shooters.
That's awesome.
They also have to take tests, so there's an educational aspect of it too, so I really like that.
And I learned that coming out here, there's that test is like 20%.
Yes.
So you can shoot awesome, but if you don't do well on the test, bad news. So you got to kill it in both sides.
Yeah, and we start studying. We start usually late October, early November. We start studying as soon as we begin our season. Our kids start taking tests.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much for taking the time. And thanks for all you do getting the kids here
and
for what you guys are doing.
It is my privilege. You know, one other thing that I really like about bringing the kids here is we watch the team camaraderie. We've been shooting together, but we know a lot of other people from our state. And you watch these kids gather in groups and play games and just, you know, get to know kids from all across the country. And I love that aspect of it.
I have been watching that myself. It's actually pretty endearing
yes.
to see the kids around a table playing cards and having fun. And there's a lot of downtime here. I mean, you guys probably won't notice it in the episodes, but you guys shoot for like eight, it's like an 8-hour match for 2 days. To get everybody cycled through. So there's a lot of downtime. There's a lot of mental discipline that goes on with the shooters that are fixing to get ready to go shoot. So it is, it's arduous. I don't know how else to put it. It's a lot of.
We've been training for all year for this.
Yeah, and then you see them over here playing cards and sitting up playing checkers and just having a good time. It is pretty cool to see
that. Yes, absolutely.
So, well, thank you again. I appreciate it.
So as the competition came to a close, every shooter, down to the very last one, did their best to score well for their team, but only one team could take home the title of BB Gun National Champion.
We got the three top teams in the national championship match. In third place, with a total score of 2,363 with 70X, is Marshall County, South Dakota, the Marshall County Sharpshooters. Mike Kraft and Harlan Hillison with William Cutler, Jaden Bender, Erica Simons, Lexi Cutter, and Katie Freeman. Coming in second place in this national championship match with 2,382 with 87X, Walton County, Georgia, the Walton County 4-H team, coached by William Carlin and Jamie Goida. Team members are Anthony Stacy, Daisy Teague, Breanne Jones, Joshua Shirley, and Levi Fuller. All right, gold medal, first place. And it wins our prestigious traveling trophy. It's the Stanley Cup of BB gun shooting in the 2019 54th Annual Daisy National BB Gun Championship match. With a score of 2,385, 85X, from Pierre, South Dakota, the Pierre Junior Shooters. Coached by Jonathan Hayes, Sean Krueger. Team members are Riley Stoser, Griffin Gates, Jenna Krueger, Skylar Ruth, and Samuel Sterling.
We're here with the winners of the 54th Annual Daisy Nationals Competitions from Pierre, South Dakota. These guys crushed it, and I want to hear from the kids here what this means to them. They had to fight to get here because this isn't just show up and shoot. You got to qualify regionally, you got to win something at state, and then you got to get here and crush it. Is that basically the scoop? All right, you guys tell me what you love about this sport. Anybody can jump in. Go.
Oh. family.
Okay, you got family. What else?
All the work you have to do in it. It's right. Really fun working together.
Right. Anybody else? What about you? What do you love about the sport?
Fun to shoot.
It's fun to shoot. Anybody else? Well, you ladies, you guys did really well, didn't you? They're very shy. They nodded. I guess that's good. You guys really had a good time? Do you like traveling?
Yeah.
Right. Why do you like shooting BB guns?
Not as expensive as high-powered rifles.
Because you can, that's a good one. They're not as expensive as high-powered rifles. How often do you guys train? It's got to be like 5 hours a day, right? Two or three times a week, okay.
We meet once or twice a week, but individually we also practice.
How many of you guys have a range at your house? Yeah, I got one at my house. And how often do you spend time on your home range?
Whenever we need to practice and fix something.
There you go. And you guys were talking about the different positions. Standing is a tough one.
Yeah.
That one takes the most strength, and it takes a lot of discipline to really get good at that. Anybody shoot a perfect standing today?
No.
No? Okay. Well, anybody shoot perfect today?
No.
So you guys were just consistency, right?
Yeah.
Everybody shot consistently, and you all did well. You all got really good on your test, too. Did you guys, like, tie up for the high score on the test?
Yeah.
So you got the education side, you got the shooting side, and you guys crushed it, and you're national champions. How awesome is that? Coaches, you're not getting out of it. You're going to have to talk. You guys tell me why you love doing this with these kids.
That's rewarding. See them succeed.
Yep.
But I go along with the same thing. I also like seeing them when something finally clicks, and they look at you, they give you that big smile, like, ah, I got this.
Go, Pigeon Shooters! All right, everybody! Woo! All right, everybody, these are your national champions, the Peer Junior Shooters from South Dakota. My name is Rick Utzer here with AirgunWeb, AirgunWeb TV. You guys stay tuned next year. I hope to be here again, and maybe you guys, well, not you guys, it'll be a whole other group, won't it?
Yes.
Maybe we'll see a repeat. Thanks for watching.